Good morning, students. This is Amitabh Ghosh from Great Mission Public School, Himmatpur Block. And as you know, I'm your computer science teacher. Yesterday, I gave you a brief introduction about your topic. I hope you may have some idea whatever I gave you in your video lecture and a short clip. So we will continue all the topic that we have in this particular chapter in detail, and in the coming videos I'm going to show you practical view of solving each and every problem. So please stay tuned with my videos. Okay, thank you.
Students, so we are in a second day of your third chapter, that is on multimedia. Yesterday I already defined you the definition and tried to explain you what is multimedia called. I also guide you what are its elements that is used in multimedia. Today I will continue yesterday's topic in a bit detail, that is types of multimedia. Yesterday I showed you there are four common types of multimedia, that are text, audio, graphics and video. Based on these four multimedia elements, the fifth multimedia element is animation, that consists of all these four elements. So today I will tell you about more details on these five multimedia elements. So as I said yesterday, that first multimedia element is text. Text is nothing but whatever you are writing or typing in a document file, like word, sentence, paragraphs, formatting of text comes under text multimedia elements. Now these text elements are written or typed using different type of softwares that I already told you yesterday. One of the basic multimedia text editor is Notepad, which you are already familiar with. Now let's say I'm writing tutorial of class 4. Now something I already wrote here. Now if I want to increase the size of text, I have to select the entire text, go to format, click on fonts, increase the size of fonts, select the type of font and its type. Let's say I chose Constantia bold with a font size of 20. So preview of this font is showing over here. Now when you click on apply or OK, the size of the font changes and style also changes accordingly. So depending on the type of text that you type in using editor, you can have different type of alignment or format, which looks a soothing view when somebody checks the content of your file. The other popular editor, which is also known as multimedia editor, is Word. Now when you click on Word, you will find different type of extras, features that is not available in Notepad but is available in Word, like many menus which have different features is showing when you click on it on each tab of the menu bar, which will show you different type of layouts, designs, then styles. All these things you can do using Word, which cannot be possible using Notepad. So these are the two common but most powerful text editor that we use for text element. The next one is audio multimedia element. Now what is it? Anything or any sound that you hear comes under audio. Like if you are singing a song, if you are listening a song, if you are recording your voice, all these things comes under audio elements. Now using microphone, you use a microphone is a multimedia device. You can record your voice, but if you want to listen any song, you have to use a software to listen that song. So the two most common audio multimedia is VLC player, which looks like this with a symbol like this, and the other one is Windows Media Player. Let me search it for you. See this with the logo of a player. So these are the two common multimedia elements that you have in your course. Here you can listen a song, even you can use pictures in a multimedia player. Let me show you by dragging and dropping a multimedia picture. Let me see if I find any. Let's say picture is not available here. Let me go and search if I can find here. Web is it is not available here. Code. See, there are different pictures. Let's say I'm taking this picture and I'm dropping it in a VLC player. So this particular multimedia software, VLC software, can play audio files, graphics file or picture files, as well as video files. Nowadays every multimedia player like VLC, Windows Media Player, VL Player, there are various softwares available in the market which can play audio, video, as well as graphics. Now what is graphics? Graphics is something which comes or which you will see in the form of a picture or an image. This picture I have opened in an image editor. So any image that you see through your eyes comes under graphics. Graphics is a combination of different type of colors put together by giving different type of shapes. As this is a globe or the earth that you are seeing, so it has different type of colors with different light effects, so it comes under graphics. So different pictures can be seen using image editor or, as I said, multimedia player like VLC. Now what is video element? Video element is something that you can see in motion. If you play any file, it has a sound, it has a picture, as well as it has image or the text that you see while playing any video file. Let me check if I have one. Hold on a minute. Let me see if any file is available. let's say I'm opening a video file which is showing over here. So by default it is opening in a VLC player. So did you see that? So anything, any image that runs in a different frame when it is played in a sequence, it looks like that file or a clip has a motion. So it comes under video file. See this? So every picture is in
4 stars general. United States military may say badkar.
Same video file can be played using Windows Media Player also. If I right click and if I try to open this file in Windows Media Player, see this? So the file can also be played using Windows Media Player. Let me close this one. So final one is your animation multimedia element. Now what is an animation? In your last class, that is in class 3rd, you already have learned from Rekha ma'am that any pictures when run in a frame, not only single picture, when multiple pictures runs in a frame and when it is played in a player, it looks like it is in motion. So cartoon or toon movies like Bheem, Shin Chan, all these type of animated movies are being created similar type of software that you might have learned last year in Pivot Animator. Let me show you that software and let me play one single file for you so that you can have an idea. So this is Pivot Animator software which is used for creating animation. So let me load some file so that you can have an idea. Let's say, see, there are different type of frames which have a different motion. Now when I play this frame, it is showing here total frames are 121 frames. That means 121 images with different movement has been placed in a frame. Now when I click on play, you check the screen. It looks like that this horse is doing some movement. So as because there are 121 frames, so this particular animation has been framed in such a way that it will create a small video clip. So I hope you have an idea of different type of multimedia elements that I told you or discussed today: text, graphics, audio, video and animation. Tomorrow I will discuss the next topic, which is on multimedia devices. Multimedia devices are maybe software or it is hardware that is used to play these multimedia files. Okay, so see you then tomorrow. Goodbye, students.